Okay, so hi everybody. My coworkers and me are glad to be here today to present the collaborative work we did together the last few months about learning packaging technology. So first, let me introduce who we are and what we do. So Patrick and I are from IFREMER, which is an oceanographic research institute, and Valentin and Olivier are working at INRA, which is an agronomic research institute. So we are four engineers in two bioinformatic teams located in two different parts of France. IFREMER is located in the west part of France, and INRA is close to Paris. One major part of our work is to provide bioinformatic tools to our scientist community. So we are used to install and upgrade hundreds of tools, which are more or less easy to install. And sometimes we have to install some pipelines with a lot of dependencies, and this can be really, really difficult. That's why we were wondering how we could facilitate such installation for all the bioinformatic teams. Okay, so today we're going to present how we managed to package a pipeline called FROGS.
So actually FROGS is a meta-barcoding data analysis tools designed to run on the Galaxy platform. It was first released by 2015, and actually that tool was made at INRA in France. The pipeline is made of two main parts. You have the bioinformatics analysis part you can use to pre-process your reads, to cluster them, to compute taxonomic units, and so on. And then you have, on the other hand, the biostatistical part you can use to run data visualization or diversity analysis. FROGS was presented 2 years ago at GCC. It is quite a nice tool to be used by biologists because, as I said, it is available from the Galaxy platform. However, it's also available to be used from the command line if you prefer to do so. The tool is quite successful. We have some numbers here. Until now, we trained more than 200 people to use FROGS. We have 17 papers citing the tool. FROGS is quite nice for users. However, as software engineers, when we want to install the software, it's really, really more difficult to use.
Yeah, that's true. Before the work is done, to install GitHub on your to install FROGS on your own infrastructure, you needed to download all the source code and all the wrappers of FROGS. So the 20 wrappers, you needed to download them and install them manually in your infrastructure. Also, FROG has it's a pipeline, so it has a lot of dependencies. All these dependencies, you needed to retrieve them on different websites and also install them manually on your infrastructure. Lot of dependency means also some conflict aversion. You can have conflict between these dependencies or between these dependencies and the one that have been already installed in your infrastructure if you don't use virtual environments. So as previously said, Patrick, for the user, FROGS is right accessible because you can use command line or the interface of Galaxy. But for the administrator or people in charge of tool installation as us, it's much more difficult because you need to make all the installation manually. So we were wondering how to automate the installation process to be able to have a FROGS pipeline fully accessible for everyone. So we were wondering which technology to use for that. So I will reassure you, we don't study all this technology. In fact, it was pretty easy to choose. We just followed the Galaxy community advice. As it to use the Conda technology package. So Conda, for those who don't know, it's a technology which can allow you to install your tool with just one command as an apt-get install. and it also allow you to manage some virtual environments. And more especially, we wanted to publish the tools on the Bioconda repository to have a better visibility on the biological community. Also, we wanted to publish the wrappers made by the Frogs dev team on the toolshed to have a better visibility, and to allow the administrator to install it with just one click button with the Galaxy interfaces. And so, for publish the tool on the toolshed, we wanted the tool to follow the best practices of Galaxy. So for that, we use the tool Planemo, which is a tool in one end that can help people which want to make their own tool on Galaxy to create it. And in the other end, it's a tool that can help people to ensure that the wrappers follow the best practices, and in particular that can launch some tests. The key issue for us when we start the job was that we don't have any experiences in some packaging technology, and we wanted to figure out whether or not this technology was easy to learn. Also, we wanted to know if we will be able to package frogs in a reasonable amount of time. So we have tried them on frogs.
Now let's see how we organize our work. As a reminder, we are two teams in two different locations. So we organize some collaborative work session every 2 weeks using the website Appirin to run some online meetings. We also use some virtual machines provided by the French Institute of Bioinformatics Cloud, on which we use a magical Unix command screen to share terminals. So we can review code and text, we can execute tools, and we can control the logs. And we also use, as our favorite and very user-friendly text editor, the VI editor. We also organize some regular meetings with the Frogs development team, so we can tell them about our achievements.
So now let's review the a summary of the 11 steps we went through to prepare the packaging of the entire Frogs pipeline. These are the steps we follow, but maybe this could also more generally be the step you could follow also to distribute your tool to the community. So the first step, the basic one, the one who we prefer to do, read the manuals. So we went through the Galaxy training network materials, which was very helpful for us to find a way to figure out how to set up the Conda packaging, for instance. So the first real step was to check whether or not the many dependencies of Frogs were available in the different Conda channels. And actually we were quite lucky because all but one of these packages were available. And as stated by Laure earlier, we used to work 1 day every 2 weeks. So regarding the remaining not available package in Conda, two solutions for us. We do the packaging, or we just wait for someone else that did the work. And actually, this is exactly what happened. So we didn't have to do that. So simply proceed to the next step.
So the next step was to create this Conda environment for Frogs, in which we install all the dependencies. But we went into trouble because there were some conflicts between the dependencies provided by Conda and the ones that were that the dev team suggest to us. So as a solution for this problem, we just let Conda install the compatible versions of dependencies. But next, in this environment, we install Frogs manually and try to run the unit test. But they failed, and they failed because the dependencies installed by Conda were not compatible with our source code.
So here the solution we retained was to set precisely the version numbers for all the dependencies. So that means we set major, minor, and patch release numbers for all the dependencies. Yeah, that's it for me. Sorry.
So to do that, we write a Conda recipe for frogs, but Conda complains because we were specifying two specific dependencies for the libraries, for the dependencies.
So here, what we had to do actually is to set only major and minor version numbers for all the dependencies, so that we were able to have a running environment for frogs, but also to have a valid recipe to be used by Conda to run the build itself. So after that, we were able to proceed to the next steps quite easily. So we were able to run all the test suite of frogs successfully. Then we set up a personal Conda channel so that we were able to upload, install, and test again that everything were fine for the installation and test of frogs. And as a final step for that part, we were able to deploy for the first time the full Frogs pipeline as a Conda package within the BioConda channel.
Then we have to check the 20 Frogs wrappers using Planemo. So we added some sections into the wrappers, like the requirement section, in order to link with the Conda package we just created. We also added the STDIO and test sections because there were no functional tests provided by the development team, so we had to create them and to add them to the wrappers. So once we have validated the wrappers with Planemo, we uploaded them on the test toolshed. And as a final step, which was a kind of crash test, we decided to create a fresh Galaxy instance in which we installed the tool from the pipeline from the toolshed. And we decided to use this instance to run 3 days of trainings of frogs. And fortunately, it was a success. Everything works.
So as a summary, today, frogs is available as a Conda package through the BioConda channel. It has been downloaded 240 times since the last 6 months. And so the wrappers are available in the test toolshed. We still need some people to test the pipeline and to fix the last issues.
So as a conclusion for that work, actually we had two questions in mind. Are these packaging technology easy to learn? We will be able to package frogs in a reasonable amount of time, and actually the answer to these two questions is definitively yes. So hopefully we're going to publish the full package of frogs in the toolshed by autumn this year.
We would also like to give you some take-home messages, especially if you are developing some tools. A good idea if you want to have a tool which is visible and accessible is to provide a Conda package. But if you use Conda, be careful of the way Conda will install the dependencies. You can have conflicts in version. Be careful to the Conda channel holder also, because you also can have some problem with the versions. Please, if it's possible, provide us some functional tests. So as administrator, we can easily control and verify that the tool is well installed on our system. If the tool you are developing is maybe too complex, you can think about separate into the Conda package into different parts. For example, with frogs, we had a bioinformatic part and a statistical part, so we could have separate into Conda environments. And finally, a good another idea is to use a login framework so we can easily debug your tools. And something is to avoid is to use the dev null redirection, because you can hide some really precious problems for debugging tools. So thank you for listening to us. I would also like to thank Geraldine and Maria from the Frogs development team, the Galaxy and Boss community to let us present this talk. And please apologize for our terrible French accent. Thank you.